Okay? Hello and good day everyone, no? So today we will discuss naman, no, about the laws of exponent, I mean logarithmic function, no? Okay? So may mga laws din yung logarithmic function. Here, logarithm of a product, no? In a logarithm of a product, no? Meron tayong sinusunod na form, we have log pq base of n is equal to log p base of m plus log q base of m. So dito, instead na i-multiply natin, i-add natin. Instead na i-add, i-multiply. Sa rule ng logarithm yon. Example here, log st base of x, ano yung, following the logarithm of a product, no? We will write it in log s base of x plus log t base of x. No, pag-iwalayin natin sila by plus sign. Okay? Next, about this one. Log a base of 5 plus log b base of 5. Simplify, no? Plus yan, multiply natin. Log a b base of 5. Pwede to as long as parehas yung base, ha? Applicable basta parehas yung base. Pero pag magkaiba yung base, no need. Hindi mo pwedeng galawin. Okay? Number 3. Show that log 4 times 5 base of 3 is equal to log 4 base of 3 plus log 5 base of 3. So how can we verify that form, no, or this expression is equal to this one? Okay? So log 4 times 5 base of 3 is equal to log 4 base of 3 plus log 5 base of 3. No? So if we multiply this one, 4 times 5 is 20. And this one, following this rule, No. Hindi pala. Using calculator, no? Okay, input niyo yung log 20 base of 3 sa calculator, the result is 2.7268. Okay? Again, sa calculator ulit, input niyo log 4 base of 3, ito yung lalabas. 1.2618 sa calculator ulit. Okay, input niyo log 5 base of 3, magiging 1.4650 yung sagot. Now, add natin to 1.2618 plus 1.4650, that would be equal to 2.7268. Equal na sila. Okay? Now class, kung wala dyan sa mga calculators nyo, no, alam ko naman, hindi naman lahat sa calculator na yung ginagamit nyo usually na yung Casio pa yun, no? Kung wala dyan, kung nahihirapan kayo, try nyo sa online calculator, no? Pwede kayo mag-research ng, pwede nyo i-type doon sa Google ng online logarithmic calculator, no? Or scientific calculator. Meron doon marami sa, ano, sa websites, no? Research nyo lang or i-type nyo lang, then you can use online calculator na. Marami. Meron pang sa pang-radical, no? Sa mga square roots, radical and roots, no? Mas madali doon. I-input nyo lang yung index, i-input nyo lang yung radicand, then equal lalabas ng value. Okay? Dito naman, sa ano, ang ginagamit ko is online logarithmic calculator na maraming lalabas doon na klase. Pili na lang kayo kung ano yung mas prefer sa inyo. And then, here, another law of logarithm is yung logarithm of a quotient, no? So this one we have here. Ito yung form na sinusunod natin. Log p over by q base of n is equal to log p base of n minus log q base of m. Ito yung simplified form. Ito yung expanded form niya. Okay? Kung sa multiplication, add. Sa division, subtract. Okay? Example this one. Log 56 over by 18 base of x. Expand natin yan, magiging log 56 base of x minus log 18 base of x. Okay? Another one. Ito, simplify natin. Log u base of 7 minus log v base of 7. Simplified form, we have log u over by v base of 7. No? From subtraction, naging division. From division, naging subtraction. Sila yung magpartner. Eh. Another one, logarithm of a power. No? Ito, log p raised to y base of n is equal to y log p base of n. So yung exponent, lilipat lang dito. Okay? Natural law yan. Example here, we have log 11 cube base of m. No? So simplify natin, magiging 3 log 11 base of m. Ito exponent. So yung mga examples natin before na may number dito sa una ng log, exponent yon. Another one, how about this one? 7 log a base of 2, na i-expand natin, now we have log a raised to 7 over, I mean, base of 2. Okay? So na lang. How about this one? 1 half log 8 base of x, no? That is equal to log square root of 8 base of x. Or log 8 raised to 1 half. 1 half yung exponent, no? Kung simplify natin siya, magiging square root of 8 yun. Change of base theorem, no? Another one here. We have log n base of m is equal to log n base of p over by log m base of p, no? So dito sa change of base theorem, usually ginagamit to sa buko. Okay. Pag kukuha ng value or pag i-evaluate, no? Here, example this one. Log 15 base of 3. No? Sa ano yung pwedeng maging value ni log 15 base of 3? Okay? So gagawin natin dito pag ihiwalay natin, no? Okay? Yung log p dito, yung base of p, wala to ha. Magiging 15 yung isa, log 15 over by log 3. Now, using calculator, no? Okay. Input natin log 15, walang base. Log 15, that would be equal to 1.1760. Sa log 3 naman, we have 0.4771. Divide natin, the value is here. No? Approximately equal to 2.4649. Okay? Or, kahit di naman natin sundin to, kung kukunin natin yung, or i-evaluate natin itong log 15 base of 3, no, kung meron kayong calculator na pwedeng i-input tong expression na to, ganun din ang lalabas. Kung wala, try nyo to sa mga calculator nyo. No, kung wala kayong calculator na pwedeng input yung ganitong form na may base. Kasi hindi lahat ng calculator may base na nilalagay. So ito yung shortcut method niya. I mean, hindi naman shortcut, no, another method, no, na mas reliable. Okay? Next, how about this one? Log 48 base of 7, no? O kung di natin magamit sa calculator to, gamitin natin yung change of base theorem. Okay? Yung itong power, no? And then yung base. No, log 48, log 7, kunin natin yung log 48, that would be equal to 1.6812. Log 7 naman 0.8451. Divide natin, then you will have 1.9894 approximately. Okay? So pinakita ko sa inyo yung another way, no? Kung nahihirapan kayo sa calculator nyo. Okay, kasi not all the time, especially sa Casio, yung mga common na mga calculators, I mean scientific calculator, mahirap i-input yung may base. Nakalagay lang doon log. So we need to use this one. Okay? Or online calculator if you want. Now, write the following sa single theorem. Simplify if necessary. Okay. Here, number one, log 9 base of 3 plus log 27 base of 3. Simplify natin. Log 9 times 27 base of 3. Simplify natin. 9 times 27. That would be equal to log 243 base of 3. Exponential form, we have. Pwede pa, simplify natin yung 243. May exponential form siya. We have 3 raised to 5. And may exponent na 5, o lipat natin siya dito. 5 equal to 5, no? Tama ba? Tama. Tama, kasi maka-cancel out yung 3 sa 5 na to. Okay? So wala to dun sa rule, sa law, no? So i-include nyo na. Okay, hanggang dito, cancel out na to. Okay? we have 5 here. Yung value niya ha. Yung value ng log 9 base of 3 plus log 27 base of 3, kasi nga sabi 75 necessary. Yung pinaka simplest form na kailangan gawin natin. Okay? Next, 4 log x base of n minus 2 log y base of n. Okay, simplify natin, no? Following dalawang luto. The quotient and then the power. No? Now, simplify muna natin 'to. No? We have here 4 log x base of n magiging 4x raised to 4 base of n, and then ito naman minus log y squared base of n. And then minus siya, no? We will use the quotient. We magiging log x raised to 4 over by y squared base of n. Can we simplify this one? No? Wala akong common factor. So ito yung magiging final answer niya. Okay? Next. Given log 3 equal to 0.4771, log 4 equal to 0.6021, and to ha, log 6 equal to 0.7781, determine the value of the following. Okay, paano yun? Okay, this time given na yung ano, yung mga values of log 3, 4, and 6. Now, how can we find the value of log 24? Simply, factor yung 24 na kung saan may 4 at saka may 6 or may 3. Okay, dapat dalawa sa tatlong to nando doon. So I will use 6 and 4, no? So log 6 times 4. O nasa ano tayo, multiplication kasi factor ang kinuha ko eh. Now, i-separate ko. Log 6 plus log 4 following the multiplication law of logarithm. Now, what is your log 6? We have 0.7781 plus yung log 4 natin 0.6021. Add natin, then that would be equal to 1.3802. Okay? Next, log 2 thirds. No? Now, following the quotient law, no, magiging, or, sorry, kumutang ko. 2 thirds. So, hindi natin siya pwede kaagad i-rewrite into quotient. O pwede naman, kaso nga lang, wala tayong value of log 2 here. Log 3 lang. Dapat nandito lahat eh. No? Gamit lang to. So kukunin natin yung, imultiply natin siya by 2, yung 2 thirds. So magiging log 4 over by 6. Okay? Kung saan, nandito na si 4, nandito rin si 6. Okay? And then right now into quotient law, log 4 minus log 6. Yung log 4 mo is 0.6021, yung log 6 mo 0.7781. Subtract natin, then that would be equal to negative 0.1760. Okay? So that's it. No? Thank you for listening, and again, do not forget to answer your exercises. Okay? That's all. Goodbye and God bless.